Hi, I'm Vanessa, and I love bad Star Trek. I will be the brain fart heard round the world that is Star Trek the original series. Today, I'll be talking to you about an episode called Spock's Brain, which I was surprised to find out was this season 3 premiere. Wow. Talk about the beginning of the end, really. Season 3 is the least good of the three. Spock's Brain is widely considered to be the worst episode of the original series because the premise of Spock's brain being stolen by a planet of brainless people is tremendously stupid. And yeah, it is. Leonard Nimoy said that he was embarrassed by this episode, but I think there's more to it than a B-movie plot with more holes than Swiss cheese, stilted dialogue, weird pacing and acting choices, and a dumbass premise. This thing is like Mercury because it is retrograde. Even by 60 standards. There's a scene I'll talk about more later where Chief Medical Officer Bones is basically just turning to Kirk and says, "This woman's a fucking idiot," while she is standing right there. So the misogyny here is really next level. Also, a little bit of a tangent. One thing that has always been a source of amusement for me in Star Trek is how frequently it's assumed that alien species would present as sexually dimorphic folks that align with a strict male/female gender binary. And they're definitely all straight. Like there's no DuPont Circle, Boys Town, or West Hollywood anywhere but Earth. Come on. And with this comes a slight, albeit unspoken, addendum to the infamous Prime Directive, otherwise known as Starfleet's guiding principle of non-interference, which is if there is just some crazy kooky cats on a planet that are frustrated, not getting along, or worse, not getting it on, they should. And you know, Starfleet should just give them a little nudge and let nature take its course. It's honestly amazing. It would be like if Bob Vila saw a rundown Victorian house, reached into his toolbox, looked into the camera and said, "You know what'll fix this? Compulsory heterosexuality. The trusty dusty bubble level of Star Trek. Heteronormativity. Dry, unsatisfying, and inexperienced sticks just rubbing together." Because in at least one of these examples, one or more parties literally don't know how to have sex. This was done in season 2 of the original series in an episode called The Apple. And even in The Next Generation, where in Up the Long Ladder, this was kicked up several notches, where Starfleet ordered 2 human colonies to do it to make more of them. And what better pairing could there be than sex-repulsed clones and drunken Irish stereotypes? And this fucking weird-ass solution is just one layer in the lasagna of shit that is Spock's brain. You know, like, it's really something to go from Discovery, where representation might edge into tokenism here and there, but it is solid progress, not just for Star Trek, but for TV in general, to an episode where they straight up just say, "Women are fucking stupid," and comp-het a whole planet. Like, it's just like going from a jacuzzi to jumping right into Lake Michigan on New Year's Eve. We are freezer burning the nips right off with this polar plunge. I blame my mom, who is making me do this. Okay, she isn't making me, she just strongly suggested it because I showed this to her over Christmas break and she thought it was horrible. So here we go. The robbery of Spock's brain is no Ocean's 11. It's more like Ocean's 2, boobs. 2 scoops of boobs in a Raisin Bran box colored outfit. It's as if everyone's brain was already gone when all someone had to do was beam aboard in shiny purple garters, which made everyone on the bridge into a Tex Avery cartoon. And she pushes a few buttons on her Apple Watch to knock the entire crew out. Even my mom was like, "They're in space. Can't they lock the fucking door?" Like, And she's right. This episode started with them in red alert. So why were the shields not up preventing transport? You know I should know better than to try to make sense of this episode, but damn it, I can't help it. The cold open ends with the shiny purple mystery lady squeezing Spock's head like a cantaloupe at the grocery store. And after they all wake back up, Bones tells Kirk to report to sick bay in a real hurry because he's got some real bad news, which is confirmed when Spock is on the bio bed on life support. And Bones is really hesitant to answer because it's going to sound much dumber out loud than in his notes, I'm sure. Or DeForest Kelly, the man playing Bones, is like, I just don't make me say it. Like, if I don't want to say it, maybe this whole thing will stop if I just don't say the line.
What do you mean? Jim, come on, Bones, what's the mystery? His brain is gone.
It's gone, daddy, gone.
His brain is gone.
But he informs Kirk that Spock's brain has been surgically removed. Bones said, well, he is stable on life support, but he has no mind. Which is the thing that makes the crew go, gasp! Not when they heard when the brain was surgically removed. Like, they're having a bit of a delayed reaction here, giving credence once again to my theory that everyone's brain was already gone before she got there, which thankfully Kirk immediately knows took it. Like, this episode isn't spent trying to figure out who did it, which would make this even more painful to watch. Bones is uncertain how long he'll survive without the brain, and Kirk's like, okay, I guess we'll go look for it. And Bones has a very strange reaction to this plan. And I have no idea what emotion is being conveyed here with the lines or DeForest Kelly's acting. I don't know. He's like, where could it be though, Jim? Where are we gonna look for Spock's brain? Even if you do find it, I can't put it back. I don't have the medical technique. So many terrible but classic Bones lines right in a row, you know? Jesus. But then suddenly Bones tells Kirk that they have 24 hours to put the brain back into Spock's body, which is so weird. So Bones went from not knowing how long he'll last to knowing exactly how long he'll last without the brain. And after the Enterprise follows an ion trail that ends in a star system, Chekhov gives a PowerPoint presentation to the bridge to decide what planet Spock's brain should be in, and it becomes a hot debate on the bridge because one of the planets is in a glacial age. They got like basic cable, 8 tracks and vans with wizards airbrushed on the side, like cave paintings. Just super primitive. But there's energy coming off of that planet, and another planet is more advanced with some razor flip phones and JNCO pants and spermy eyebrows, but not advanced enough to have ion propulsed engines. And Kirk goes, well, that energy, it's real, it's there. To the Batcave, I mean to the transporter, to go down to go get Spock's brain. Because if they don't, Spock will die, as he reminds us twice in a row.
A hunch, Captain. A hunch, Mr. Sulu.
What if you guess wrong, Captain?
If I guess wrong, Mr. Spock is dead.
And it's also weird that Uhura asked Kirk, like, what they would want with Spock's brain, because they'd already been flying for 15 hours before then. Like, no one thought to ask that question before Uhura said it. What the hell were they all doing for 15 hours? Just sitting around mentally playing Pong, like, just a single brain cell just pinging from one side of their skull to the other, which is even clearer when they beam down to a glaciated planet with no jackets on. Kirk even makes a comment to Chekhov, like, oh wow, you got real thick skin, like making allusion to the fact that he is Russian and therefore resistant to cold. Where's your jacket, Mr. Advanced Spaceman? Calling the people on this planet primitive, and you can't even put on a fucking sweater. When the primitive people get closer, Kirk's like, set your phasers on stun. I want them conscious. Oh yeah? How is the stun setting supposed to accomplish that? Like, who wrote this? A baby? I love that what the primitive people are wearing too, like a Doris Day haircut with straight across bangs and big beards and some faux leg warmers with a mini skirt and leggings. It's like someone's going to a club in Chicago. And Kirk shoots one of the guys who passes out unconscious. Like, that's what stun does. So they, you know, slap him and wake him up to interrogate him. And Kirk goes, hey man, it's a real sausage party up here. Where's the chicks? Where's the women? Where's your girlfriend? Don't you have a girlfriend? And this dirty berries and cream guy who doesn't have a name says, I don't know what a woman is, but there's givers of pain and delight, and they live around here and they come after us occasionally. And Kirk is really focused on whether this random caveman is getting laid. Like, what the fuck does that have to do with finding Spock's brain?
Don't you have a mate?
Mate?
A companion.
But see, Kirk sees man and he's like, you're a man. Where's the women? Just imposing heteronormative shit based on no data whatsoever. And I know this is a stupid episode, but this line of logic is not an isolated incident in Star Trek. So it doesn't get less stupid when McCoy beams down Spock with him, who has no brain, so he's ticking when he walks because he's like a clockwork mouse. That's what they're doing. Sometimes he's ticking when he's walking, sometimes he's not. It's like they just forgot to put that sound effect over it. I don't know what this outfit is giving me. Inmate, maybe earth tone, so maybe a cult member. Their reason for having Spock down there was to get his brain back into his head as soon as they find it. Why not just beam his brain back into a skull and they find some elevator to go down into the where the women are, and this leaves Chekhov above ground and he shoots a rock to heat it up rather than just putting on a fucking jacket. Put on a jacket. When the elevator opens up, there's like this woman that sees them and she reaches for her Apple Watch, but Kirk's stuns her, knocking her unconscious, which is what stun does. And they wake her up to ask her where's Spock's brain, but she doesn't know what any of that means. And she just says, like, you're not Morg or I'm Morg. Kirk says, like, where are we? And she says, well, we're here. And that's when Bones interrupts and goes, Jim, listen, she's a fucking idiot. She has no idea what you're saying or anything.
What are you?
Jim, it's no use. You'll get nothing out of that one. Hers is the mind of a child.
She has the mind of a child, even though she's a grown-ass woman. And we later find out they just have different words to refer to stuff. It whatever. Meanwhile, Scotty somehow rigs one of the communicators to actually talk to Spock's brain, which has Bluetooth. It's like a Bluetooth speaker. And Scotty says, where are you?
Mr. Spock, where are you?
Engineer Scott as well. Unfortunately, I do not know where I am.
And because this episode has to keep going, he says, I don't know. And that's when the purple lady shows up and knocks them all unconscious again. Lots of getting unconscious and conscious again. And they wake up with literal belly buttons. And it happens again where they're called, where they say women are stupid, when Kirk is trying to ask what this one woman was doing on their ship before. And Bones says, listen, she's an idiot too. You can stop.
I saw you on my ship.
Jim.
She may not remember or even really know. Disassociation could be complete. Doesn't seem possible she could have performed surgery on Spock.
I mean, stop asking them stuff. They're just dumb. They don't know what they're doing. They definitely didn't perform surgery. They don't know anything. I've scanned them and their heads are empty. What does Bones see on his tricorder? Is it just like a cartoon, like Homer's brain? Like, what is going on?
You have my undivided attention.
If they're so dumb, why are they sitting there captured? Why is it when you show some leg to a guy and they go, you're the idiot? Patriarchy is such a fucking trip. They just can't conceive of being bested by women, so they have to be dumbasses, right? And they had to use their feminine wiles instead of just sitting there slack-jawed and having Spock's brain gets stolen. Maybe they could have sounded the intruder alert back on the ship. After some painful dialogue with the purple lady looking off into space, Kirk finally finds out there's a supercomputer running the place, which is a very common theme in the original series. But what isn't as common is someone being triggered by the word brain.
We just want to talk to somebody about Spock's brain, that's all.
Brain and brain, what is brain? It is controller, is it not?
It's Spock's brain that is the supercomputer. Why didn't Spock just tell them that's what was going on? There I go again, trying to make sense of this. I should stop. It just takes so long to figure that out. And Kirk tries throwing himself down as a worshiper of the brain to see it. And this is after he said he was going to take it. So of course she's not going to show it to him. And this is when the woman pushes the button again and they all like lurch over because they're in pain. But they got that same sensation without the belt before. That's how they got the belts on. Whatever. I don't know. It's just funny to watch Kirk roll around like that and be imprisoned in the same room as their tricorders and communicators, which was ridiculous. So they get in a fight with the guards while Clockwork Spock is literally just sitting there like, and it's probably Leonard Nimoy himself thinking, this is so fucking stupid. After they beat the guards, Kirk is talking to Spock's brain over Wi-Fi again. So they find the brain room with the purple lady in it who, you know, pushes their belly button so they get on the floor and twist again. And one thing I did like is how Kirk used Clockwork Spock to push her wristband button and release their belts. This is so far from being done, and being done being bad. So they force the purple woman into some Bjork-inspired headpiece to get access to the planet's supercomputer, which weirdly makes her smart, speaking in complete sentences. And she pulls out a phaser from under her skirt, which they somehow snatch back from her. Like, this scene drags on and on. Like, they're like, put his brain back. And she's like, I don't want him. We need it to run our world. And Kirk's like, you can't kill a man. And she's like, we're not killing anyone. Just around and around. And Jesus, I'm motion sick. Bones decides to put on the teacher thinking cap himself. Maybe he can absorb information about the surgery that way. It might kill me, but it's for science. And so he does, and he falls to his knees like, a child could do it. My mom loved the surgery apparatus. Spock is at least 3 feet below where Bones' hands should be. Like, is he using salad tongs on the end of his fingers? Like, why is he so high up? And the purple lady is worried that without Spock's brain, everybody's gonna die, which is reasonable, I guess. And Kirk says, listen, all you gotta do is hang out with those gross, dirty men on the surface in the cold where you don't like it and learn to build houses you don't want to live in and make babies with them, regardless of whether or not you're attracted to them, and everything will be exactly the way it should.
We will die.
No, you'll live and develop as you should have. All this shouldn't have been done for you. Now the women here below and the men here above will control together.
They will not help us without the pain.
There are other ways.
Heteronormativity, the duct tape that fixes damn near everything. Except for Spock's brain, which Bones forgets how to put back in halfway through this surgery with very unsanitary levels of sweat coming off his face. But thankfully, Spock is at that point awake enough to talk him through the rest of it. They play a little bit of Hokey Pokey.
Right forefinger.
Correct.
Right. Wrist.
And after the surgery, Spock is uncharacteristically chipper, probably because Nimoy's like, oh good, this is over, we're done, this is it. And that's it. It is ridiculous that a planet of monosyllabic, scantily clad women need a man's brain to run their planet. The constant statements about how women couldn't possibly have built this or done that or coordinated this or engineered that, it was mind-numbing. Spock's brain is a very bad and sexist episode, and even though it is campy gold, I am astonished that it was ever made. Like, subscribe, no pressure, but peer pressure. Till next time, I guess.